Welcome back to my channel. I hope you all are fine and okay in this pandemic condition. Okay? And I would like to suggest to you that please stay at home and be safe. Here we have our chapter 6, that is the identifying feeling safe, in which we have discussed many topics like to avoid, and also we learn about cylinder. Okay, we have learned to avoid and cylinder. All these figures are 3D solid shape. The difference between cube and cylinder is only that they have plane surface only, but cylinder has curved surface. Okay? It has only a plane surface like this, but it has a curve. Like this of curved surface. Okay, so there is only one difference, and its base, the base of the cube are also a plane surface, but cylinder, but in the case of cylinder it has circular base. And you have many example like matchbox, book, woofer, dialogue euro. These are the examples of cube and cuboids, and candle, torch, bottle, pipes, etc. These are the examples of cylinder. And our today's topic is sphere. This is sphere. So let us see what is the sphere. We are familiar with a geometrical shape which is known as the circle. This is the circle, and we are all familiar with this geometrical shape, and we know that it is the 2D figure because it has formed only in a single plane. That is why it is the two-dimensional figure. Okay? Just take a coin and set the coin vertically with the help of your finger, and hit the coin. Then you will see that the coin start rotation, and during this rotation you just feel like a small ball is moving or rotating. Okay, so we just hit a disk on a circular surface, and when it starts rotating, then we feel that it is a sphere or it is a three-dimensional circle. So the three-dimensional figure which is formed in the circle is called your sphere. So here we define that a sphere is a perfectly round three-dimensional geometrical solid shape. A sphere is perfectly round 3D geometrical solid shape. A sphere is a three-dimensional symmetrical solid shape is known as sphere. Okay? So this is a two-dimensional sphere and the sphere is used like this. So here we have a sphere. This is the sphere because it is the three dimensional figure. Means when we rotate a circle, then the figure is formed, imaginary figure formed. Is called sphere. Okay, so it is the sphere, and the sphere is described by its radius. A sphere is described by its radius, and if you have many examples like ball, marble, football, volleyball, etc. These are the example of sphere, because all these, that is ball, marble, football, volleyball, are all perfectly round and they are solid, three dimensional solid. So it is known as sphere. Okay? Or all the planets in the solar system are also known as sphere because they are perfectly round and 3D figure and they occupy space also. So they are known as sphere. Okay, our Earth is also sphere because you are familiar with the structure of Earth and you have seen that the Earth is perfectly round which rotates about its imaginary axis. So Earth is also an example of sphere. Okay, so I hope it is clear to all. Now let us see the next, which is known as pole. At our home, we often use an instrument to cure the oil or fuel in our motorcycle as well as in any container. A funnel, which is used to cure the heat, fuel or liquid in any container or in our auto vehicles. Okay? And the funnel, it looks like this. the funnel which is used to pure the liquid in any container. So if we hide this portion, then we get like such structure. Okay, so such type of figure is called cone. Such type of figure is called cone. And in this figure, if we rotate this figure, then we have like this structure. And here we can see that it has a circular base. And for the lateral surface, or you can say that slant surface. Okay, so we define a cone. We say that a three-dimensional geometrical solid shape which consists of circular base and curved lateral surface is known as a cone. A cone is a three-dimensional geometrical figure which consists of circular base and a curved lateral surface is known as cone. Okay, its base is circular, so it has obviously a radius. If the base is circular, then definitely it has a radius, and the radius is represented by r. And the perpendicular distance from its vertex to the center of the circular base is called its height. And the slant length height, or lateral height is known as lateral height or slant height. So this is known as its lateral height. So this is the cone which consists of circular base and a curved lateral surface. It is called a curved cone. And the most interesting example of the cone is the ice cream, and I know that you all like ice cream. So that when you go to market and buy ice cream, then we have a cone, a container like this, which filled with like this. Okay, so that it is called a cone. Only the shaded area represents cone. This is the cream only which are edible and weak. eat deep. It is the ice cream. So ice cream is also an example of food. So it is known as cone. I hope it is clear to all what is the cone. A cone is the three-dimensional geometrical figure which consists a circular base and a curved lateral surface. It's called a cone. Okay. Now let us see our next topic. Okay, students. So I hope it is clear to all what is the sphere and what is the cone. And our next topic is prism. The prism are of many types, and according they are formed by the faces. If a prism is formed with rectangular face, then it is known as rectangular prism. If a prism is formed with rectangular face, then it is known as triangular prism, and so on. So that in the prism, a prism is three-dimensional geometrical figure in which two faces are parallel and other face are formed with rectangular face. So such type of prism which is formed is called oblique prism. Okay? A prism is a three-dimensional geometrical figure which consists two parallel faces and other faces are formed with rectangles. Then the structure is called prism. We have such type of structure. I think it is not possible to understand. So I just draw like this. This is known as the prism. So I will define the prism in my next video again. A prism is a 3D figure in which two faces are parallel. Or you can say that a prism is a three-dimensional figure in which three triangular faces are joined together ending off at a vertex. It is called a prism. In this figure, we can see that three rectangular faces are joined together ending at the vertex. So it is called a prism. I hope it is clear to all. If you have any doubt, then please come in to me. I will try to clear your doubt. And if you like the video, then please share this video to other students who can also take benefit of this video. So thank you very much for watching this video.